What's up, guys? It's Tyler Prime. We are now gonna watch 5 disturbing true swimming pool horror stories. We're gonna only do 3. So it looks like it's zooming in so my mom won't get bored, so let's do this. Pool horror stories. Okay, let me read this. Story 1 and 2, Animus. Story 3, Jared Capps. And story 4, Kylie Animus, or whatever, just whatever. And Kyla Greenhouse. Let's just watch this. Sometimes I can't pronounce stuff right.
Approaching the end of summer,
story
and my
one.
Friends and I wanted to do some cool, mischievous things before going back to school. So, we had the genius idea one night to sneak into a nearby community pool. It was actually only a couple blocks away. It's right smack in the middle of a residential area. So instead of sitting on a main road or something, it actually just sat around a bunch of houses on a quiet road.
Mm-hmm.
During the hot day, the little parking lot would be full, and the spot would be bustling. But at 1 in the morning, the place was, of course, dead. There's obviously a big fence surrounding the whole front entrance, as well as a cage that gets closed up when the place closes. So our best way was to get in through the side. We snuck into the backyard of a neighboring house and hopped the fence over to the pool. It was as easy as that.
I don't know why you do that.
The 4 of us took off our shirts and jumped into the pool, which in retrospect wasn't smart, since any of the neighbors could have heard the splashes and just called the police.
Yep.
But we were dumb high schoolers. It was very, very dark within that hole enclosing. This pool had no lights, which is why it closed at sunset. James, Courtney, and Alyssa were on the other side of the pool, as I was just kind of doing my own thing at first, swimming around and getting my face wet.
Yeah, okay.
I saw Alyssa get out of the pool shortly after and run away.
Why?
I swam over to see what was going on. She was just going to the water fountain, though.
Okay.
The 3 of us just bopped around in the water for a bit.
Yo, imagine if some guy pranked them with a Jason mask and just start rising up with a machete. You know, like in the movies? I haven't seen them, but I know he does that.
And eventually, we heard Alyssa jump back into the pool from the other side.
Yeet.
It was too dark to see much more than her black hair covering her face.
Yeah, that's creepy.
But just then, we heard Alyssa playfully call something to us as she was walking back to the pool. The 3 of us in the pool looked at each other.
Uh-oh.
I know they were doing the same thing as me, counting heads. There were 3 of us on this side of the pool, and here came Alyssa walking over to our side.
Nope.
So who was that on the other side?
Nothing.
Alyssa got in, but the 3 of us were distracted. Looking at the head bopping around the water across the pool.
Leave.
James said across the pool, "Who is that?" Not even 2 seconds later, the head went underwater and disappeared from view.
Nope, I would leave. No, I'm not staying there. I see something like that's going down like that. No, I'm leaving. I don't care.
We took this time to whisper to each other, mostly things like, what should we do? What if that's security? Should we run?
Yes.
Suddenly I felt something grab my leg with force and
started
pulling me down into the water.
No.
I kicked, splashed, and yelled for help. James came over to pull me out of the pool, while the girls were already running for it, screaming.
Wow. No help from them, huh?
It wasn't until I got to the stairs of the pool that the grip on my leg was released and I was free. We hopped the same fence we climbed over to get in and ran all the way back to Alyssa's house. I was convinced that whoever that was a security guard. That is, until they literally tried to pull me under the water. We don't know what to think. There are a few possibilities. Maybe it was just another kid messing with us. Maybe it was a security guard who went way too far.
A security guard with face,
a dangerous
hair covering her face?
Ill intent.
I leave. I don't care about my friends. I'm leaving. I don't care what you say. Okay, story 2.
It was an ordinary day like any other. 85 degrees out, family getting ready to jump in the pool.
Alright.
I was looking for my 6-year-old brother so I could help him into the pool, but I thought I'd just wait for him in the pool instead. My parents were still inside while I got ready to jump in the pool, but I didn't. because I saw something dark sitting at the bottom of the pool. It took me a few seconds to realize it was my little 6-year-old brother at the bottom of the pool. It took my young brain a few moments to realize he wasn't playing around.
Oh, crap.
I screamed in such a loud and high pitch, you would think it was a little girl if you heard it. I remember the feeling of my skin crawling as my helpless 8-year-old self didn't know what to do.
Jump in and grab him.
My parents burst out the back door.
Is he
my
dead?
My dad dove into the pool and grabbed my little brother from the bottom.
Is he dead?
It was nothing short of a miracle that my dad managed to resuscitate him, though.
Phew, that's good.
Thereon after, we weren't allowed back into the pool unsupervised until we were both at least 10 years old.
That's good. Wait, was that it? That was the whole second story? I expected something else. Schmarr's accent is leaving me. Okay, guess that was short. It was really short. Story 3.
I remember waking up from a deep sleep and looking at the clock, seeing it was around 2 in the morning, when I heard splashes coming from my pool in the backyard.
Mm-hmm.
My bedroom window didn't have a view of the pool, so I had to run downstairs to the den to get a view. And let me tell you, I was freaking out on my way down there, especially given that I live alone. The blind was shut, but the windows were open, and I could still hear a little splashing coming from the pool.
Let's get the hell out of me.
I had to be quiet opening the blinds, otherwise I risked exposing myself. I lifted the blinds only enough to get a view of the pool, but the splashing stopped. I waited a few minutes before deciding it was safe to go outside.
What? No.
I walked up to the pool.
Nope.
And nearly had a heart attack when I saw a body submerged underwater on the shallow end. I pulled the body out of the water, hoping it was more than just a body still, but he didn't seem to be breathing. I looked around my yard in a panic, and by an off chance, caught a glimpse of somebody standing in my bushes.
No. Uh-uh.
I ran back inside of my house and called 911. The police arrived surprisingly quickly and followed me to the backyard to find nothing but an empty pool. The body was gone, and so was the person standing in my bushes.
So the person was trying to throw a body he killed into the pool just to sabotage him. That's geez, like. Man, these stories are short. I'm guessing they have to do this whole thing. I was going to do part 1 and 2, but these stories are short.
This happened when we were
staying
in a small country inn. It was a family trip to some distant resort where our extended family would be meeting us.
All right.
It was such a long drive, however, that we needed to stop for the night. The inn was across the street from some big fruit stand and some crops. Other than that, it was thick forest in every direction. There were a couple other cars parked in the parking lot, so we weren't the only ones. We were out there after eating dinner at some small diner, so the day was basically over.
Uh-huh.
The sun had set, but it was still early and we didn't know what to do. So we decided to hop in the pool that the inn surprisingly had. There was no one around to stop us, so as far as we knew, it was allowed. We kind of just played typical pool games that we played ever since we were little kids. Like Shark.
Okay. Karen,
we thought it being dark made it more fun, even though it was kind of creepy being surrounded by nothing but forest for miles.
For whatever reason,
I was peering over to the woods. There was a guy just standing by a couple trees. He didn't appear to be attempting to hide or anything.
Slender Man?
It was blatantly obvious he was glaring over to us.
Is it Slender Man?
I did a little side head nod to my brother to let him know what I saw. He looked over and said, Jesus Christ, that's creepy.
No, you think?
The man then walked over to the poolside and took a seat on one of the lounge chairs. He just looked at us and said, wonderful night for a swim, huh?
No.
And then a pretty off-putting chuckle. My brother and I did our little fake polite laughs and said, yeah. Meanwhile, all that we were thinking was, alright, it's time to get out of the pool.
Yep.
But I guess we didn't want to make it obvious that we were leaving because of him. It was so painfully uncomfortable that my brother and I didn't even speak to each other. Then the man got up, still watching us, and walked over literally to the edge of the pool and just stood there looking down at us.
I'd have been like, no, it isn't a good day to have a pool. Hey, Mom, we're coming in. in. Lock the doors, close the windows. Staying in here until that guy leaves. I don't care. I don't care. We're not leaving. Jeez, like, jeez.
Eventually, I asked if he worked with the hotel, and he completely ignored my question. That's when things got really uncomfortable. I whispered to my brother we should go. As soon as we started moving towards the ladder, the man started walking fast over to the ladder.
No.
So we stopped and stayed in the pool. We played it off like nothing about it was weird, but my heart was racing, and I knew my brother's was too. The pool had stairs on one side as
Sorry,
well,
keep
but
drinking
as
this.
We tried to make our way over to them, the man seemed to inch his way to the stairs too.
No.
We were trapped in there, not knowing what he was planning, but by some stroke of luck, my dad appeared from behind the corner of the building, calling us to come out of the pool. We both screamed help and accused the man of trying to hurt us. Our dad, who was much taller than the man, sized him up, pushed him, yelled at him, and threatened to call the police.
Couldn't have come back earlier, but...
He just walked away slowly as my dad yelled curse words at him. His reaction to our dad alone suggested that he had intentions of doing something wrong. Like, God forbid, kidnapping us.
If that were my uncle, I'm pretty sure he'd running around chasing him by now while was curse words. So there's one story left, so should we just continue? So it goes, I didn't know the first three were gonna be short. Okay, let's finish. What? Fine, once. This is my mom's new tablet and she's playing Pokemon Go. That's all I'm saying. Okay, that's enough. Let's finish this. It's supposed to be... Okay, let's go. And if I keep pausing, it's because I tell you what I would do in a situation like that. Okay, story 5.
I'm gonna share a very disturbing memory from my early years.
Alright.
My name is Daniel, and I was 6,
what up,
maybe
Daniel?
7 years old. Our family lived in New Jersey. Our old house was on a very quiet street. We had the same next-door neighbor living next to us for as long as I was alive.
What does that say?
One hot day, when it was just my dad home, the neighbor came over and introduced himself to me as Paul.
Paul.
He asked my dad if he could take me to his pool, and from what I remember, he seemed very genuine and nice. I guess that's why my dad let me go with him. I remember hopping around on the shallow end of his pool, and he swam in the deeper end, watching me the whole time, smiling.
Oh boy.
He asked me questions like where I go to school, what I do for fun, what shows do I like, and so on.
What?
He asked me if I knew how to swim, and I shook my head no.
Oh,
he swam over to me and started lifting my legs and arms, trying to show me how to swim.
No.
It didn't really work out, but he said he'd invite me over one night and keep helping me. Well, apparently one night was the next night. I heard splashes coming from the pool next door from my room as I was laying in bed. I opened the window and saw Paul looking up to my window, waving. He called up to my window to come on over with my bathing suit.
Did you what?
Excited
no.
by the
no.
thought of it, I threw on my bathing suit and snuck out the front door.
Why?
It's funny. I knew well enough that what
Why
I was doing
would
go against my parents, given that I knew to sneak out. That night, as we were in the pool together, Paul was extra touchy as he was supposedly showing me how to swim. But at the same time, I didn't realize what was going on. Suddenly, I heard the shout of my dad from my window. And less than half a minute later, my dad was in Paul's backyard, yelling at him, threatening to get a restraining order if he ever came near me again.
Good.
My parents had me describe what Paul did to me, and I said nothing, because that's truthfully what I believed. They told me to never speak to Paul again, and pretty soon started looking for a new house.
Good.
In the meantime, however, one night, out of curiosity, I sat up from my bed and looked out the window.
Wow.
There was Paul, standing in his pool, looking up at my window, waving me over once again, but also putting his finger on his lips, meaning to be quiet.
No.
I shut the blinds and ignored him, listening to my parents. A few nights later, around the same time, there was a knock at the window. Or at least I thought it was a knock at first. It just sounded like a loud thump. Then there was another one.
He's in the house?
I opened my window and saw Paul down below, in our backyard.
No,
he spoke up to me in a soft voice, asking me to sneak down and we'll hang out inside his house.
No.
I shut the window and went straight to my parents' room and told them.
Good.
My mom screamed at my dad to go break Paul's neck.
Good.
My mom held me in her arms as she got on the phone with the police. Meanwhile, we both heard my dad yelling incomprehensible things outside. Paul was arrested for attempting to lure a child.
Mm-hmm. Wait.
I don't know much else about what happened, though, because the next day, my mom and I stayed with my grandma until we moved to a new house. I never really talk about this with my parents, only because it's very uncomfortable to talk about. And it's also just a painful memory.
Huh. I've got a few others yet. 3 scary true horror stories, 3 scary true highway horror stories, 3 true scary airport stories. I think I saw these ones with Gator Mars. Please tell me this one. Yep. You're subscribed to Mr. Nightmare. He does all these tons of videos. And if I'm older and I was the father of that child, I would have said, you're not swimming with them. You're going to swim there, and you're just going to stay there. You understand me? Stay there. Keep away from them, or keep away from any strangers you don't know. That's about it. And that one story where the body was found in the pool, I don't know if it was sabotage. I think the guy who killed him just decided, that's the house I need to throw this body in. He saw a pool and he just threw it in, hoping he would probably leave it there in hopes the person in the house would find it in the morning. But I don't know. So, that was top 5 disturbing true swimming pool horror stories. I hope you enjoyed this. I was planning on doing 3. I did not know it was going to be short. But anyways, if you like this video, like, comment, share, and subscribe. And welcome to Scary October. That's what I'm going to call it for now on. Wham, bam, sham.